Just waiting for that one moment where he sees the ball and lifts.
A cat playing with a mouse.
James Trafford with his first save.
You just know that he is going to get back there in 0.2 seconds because of how fast he is.
Very rapid.
Really likes the aggressiveness, the sort of getting in people's faces, the tackles, the physicality.
I feel like he's a player that in a few years' time we could be talking about as one of the best centre-backs in the league.
Grace under pressure for some of our injuries. Lovely curl!
Hello and welcome to Series 4 of Premier League Rising Stars presented by Hublot. Yes, we're back once again to take a look at the young talent lighting up the Premier League, all in with a chance of winning this very trophy. And I'm delighted to say we're joined once again by our favourite shot stopper. It is, of course, Ben Foster. Ben, good to be back.
Good to be back. We've seen some real rising stars this season and I can't wait to talk about it.
So many great players to chat about. And we're also alongside, for the very first time, the wonderful Harriet Pryor. Harriet, welcome.
Thank you. It's so nice to be here. And I'm really excited to chat through some of the names today.
Yeah, so looking forward to it. So let's get into it. This series, each episode, we're going to be focusing on specific positions and profiling a selection of young players across all Premier League clubs who have particularly performed in those positions. And given that we have our very own expert in the studio, where better to start than at the back with your fellow goalkeepers, Ben, and defenders too. Now, there aren't many goalkeepers who are young enough and getting enough minutes, but someone who is Burnley's James Trafford. Ben, what do you make of him?
I feel for him. I do. I really feel for him. It's been a real tough season for James. Debut season in the Premier League for him in a newly promoted team as well. It's always going to be difficult. You know, Burnley have struggled a lot this season. But I think the bit that I really like about James is the way that he just, you know, he's going to be there. You know, he's going to stand up. You know, he's going to be counted. Big, broad shoulders. And I think he's embraced it. I really do. So I think going forward for the rest of his career, I think this is a massive step for him and something he'll look back on really beneficially.
He's shown what he's capable of, though, hasn't he, during his loan spell at Bolton and also playing in the Euros for the under-21s, where they did not concede a goal during that whole campaign. I think, as you mentioned, it's a huge step up for a player that's only played at League One level to come into the Premier League. And not just, you know, in terms of the games you're playing, but also the spotlight that you've got on you. So much pressure, so many people talking about you, the fans getting instantly on your back as soon as things don't go well. But I feel like he's retained his confidence so well. He looks like he's settled. He looks like he feels happy to be there. Definitely a few attributes I feel like he could work on. Set pieces, we know that's been a weakness of Burnley's and for him to be more imposing in those situations. But in terms of his shot stopping, his distribution, which is so key for goalkeepers now, he's really impressed.
Now, he's made some exceptional saves, hasn't he, so far this season. His best performance came against Brighton. I mean, saving 10 of the 11 shots on target, that was some display, wasn't it?
It's fantastic. Like, these are the days of being a goalkeeper that you dream about, where everything just seems to hit you. Everything is a save. It goes away. It goes for a corner. People are cheering you. This is what you live for. This is what all those hours on the training ground and practicing, it finally pays off. You don't get many of them, I promise you that. But when it does, it feels so, so good.
On to defensive players next, and a player in a team who've been praised for their defensive performances all season. It's Arsenal's Rolls-Royce of a centre-back, William Saliba. Harriet, what have you made of the Frenchman this season?
Well, just how impressive has he been? Already looks like the most calm and composed man on the pitch for Arsenal a lot of the time. And I think you can see, as soon as he drops out of the team, that win percentage for Arsenal just completely drops off. You saw that last season in particular. They were going for the title race. He got an injury and they really struggled without him. And I think that's testament to just how much he's grown.
He reminds me a little bit of a Virgil Van Dijk. The way he reads the game, how composed he is, how controlled he is. The timing of when he will do those slide tackles, he's happy running out with the ball, he's aggressive. He really is the full package of what you want from a centre-back.
Scores a few goals as well, doesn't he?
A real threat as well, a genuine threat. And we're talking about Arsenal here, you know, Arsenal who have famously, defensively and in an attacking sense, they're not really renowned for scoring goals and for keeping goals out. So he has been massive for them, getting on the end of those balls into the box, the corners, the free kicks, and at the other end as well, clearing absolutely everything for them.
I always feel like when when I see him both on and off the pitch, that he looks so calm, he looks so composed, he looks so confident. And another thing which I think is underestimated about him is the leadership qualities that he's already showing. You can tell that when he is on the pitch, he has command, he is leading the line, he knows where everyone needs to be. And I feel like when you're that age and feel like you can lead a team in that way, both on and off the pitch, you've got so much potential. I know there was a lot of conversations around how he managed to deal with Haaland as well. He is so composed, he rarely lets anyone come past him, and he just feels like he knows exactly where to position his body to really shut out strikers.
Yeah, it's like he's toying with them a little bit, timing it. It's kind of like he's running alongside. Again, it's like he's not sprinting, but he's got it all under control, and he's just waiting for that one moment where he sees the ball and lets. Thank you very much.
Yeah, what a player he is. Our next rising star is Toffee's 21-year-old Jarrad Branthwaite. He's strong, he's quick, he's powerful. Harriet, Dyche clearly trusts him in the heart of that Everton defence.
Yeah, well, you said there, he's strong, he's quick, he's powerful. He's such an imposing defender. And what I really like about him is, we were just speaking, how he went out on loan and he's come back and he's shown that improvement. And I feel like that's a really good trend for young players now, to go away, do a season, really hone their craft. And he's come back into the Premier League and really lit it up. There's so much conversation around him. He's been really impressive.
He strikes me as a real old school style defender. Really likes the aggressiveness, the sort of getting in people's faces, the tackles, the physicality, and especially
perfect for Sean Dyche.
Perfect for Sean Dyche. You know, especially in the modern era of game where it's so fashionable to be, you know, get the ball down and we play lovely football and we stroll out with it. For a 21-year-old to have that aggression and that responsibility, where he's always available, he always stands up, and you know, Everton have found it tough at times this season, but he's always been there and stood up to be counted as well.
And a left-footed centre-back, you don't see that too often. How beneficial is that to the Toffees?
He offers such a nice balance to that left side of the defence, and that is something that I think will make him so sought after for years to come, because he does offer that really nice balance and nice attributes as well. And we've got to talk about his partnership, haven't we, with Tarkowski, because just how impressive has that been? And I think the fact that he's got him alongside him, a very experienced defender, he's really thrived in that environment.
Yeah, you're talking about big units there, you know? him and James Tarkowski. You know that if you're playing against Everton, then you have to be on your toes when it comes to set. You have to be. Any Sean Dyche team, you have to be on your toes. You're going to have to think twice about it as well. You know, you might have to think, we might have to play this one short and maybe work it round a little bit, because if you're going to be putting it into that Everton box, them two are just going to be clearing it every single time.
Well, Ian Wright described him as a player who has everything and an absolute monster. I liked that as well. That seems fair too.
Exactly that. 6'5", 21 years old. He's broad, he's aggressive. Everything just seems to be a perfect fit for him. You know, Everton is a football club, the style of play, Sean Dyche, him, his centre-back partnership. He seems to have done all the right foundations, and now it's flourishing in the Premier League.
All right, the next player on our list is Alfie Doughty. He's been playing wing-back for Luton Town and is largely considered one of Luton's driving forces. Ben, it's been an amazing 5 years for him.
What I love about Alfie Doughty is it's that kind of rags-to-riches story. You know, 5 years ago, he's playing for Kingstonian in the National League, and today, look at him, he's playing in the Premier League. And I think that's just goes to show that if you're willing to put the work in and give it everything that you've got, that you can get there too. Obviously, he's had to come up through the leagues, he's had to add parts to his game, he's had to adapt. But with Rob Edwards, what they do at Luton, he's found a team, a manager that just works. You know, he's found a position for himself. You know, his set piece delivery is absolutely fantastic, and he's been a key player for him this season.
Yeah, you mentioned there him working hard. He's got that humility, clearly, hasn't he? And I think because of his story and the fact that he has started at the bottom, he's come through the leagues, he helped Luton get promoted into the Premier League, and now he's helping them at that level as well. He's one of their top chance creators, and as you mentioned, he's so good from set pieces. But just how good is he coming down that left flank as well? His wonderful left foot, putting balls into the box, into the area all the time. One of the top chance creators I mentioned. And I think as well, one thing we have to talk about when we mention him is his versatility, because just how important is it when you have a team and the season drags on a bit, you have a few injuries creep up, and you've got a player like him who can play on both flanks and cover both sides. It's really key, isn't it?
Oh, it's massive. If he can play on the right wing, play on the left wing, if you get injuries in your squad and you know that you can rotate a player over to the other side, honestly, it's like having two players. It really is two players. But as a player, you've got to have the humility, you've got to drop your ego, you've got to be willing to muck in as a team player to be able to do that, and that's obviously what Alfie is as well.
What I like about Luton as well is they haven't just sat back in their games, have they, and just set up with a low block and played really defensively. He's a fullback, but how often do you see him just darting up the pitch and really contributing in that attacking sense as well?
Mickey van der Ven is the next man under our rising star spotlight, and Harriet, he is frighteningly quick.
He is frighteningly quick, and there is a lot more to him than just the pace, but we've got to start by talking about the pace because it's quite frankly ridiculous. He set a record for speed in the Premier League, which for a centre-back is unbelievable, isn't it? But what I like about the fact that he is so pacey is that it allows Ange Postecoglou to play the system that he wants, because he plays with that high line, he sets up in that more risk and reward style of play. But if a ball comes over the top, you just know that he is going to get back there in 0.2 seconds because of how fast he is.
Am I right in saying that his top speed that he was clocked at is very similar to the world record speed that Usain Bolt set, the average Usain Bolt speed for when he set the world record? That's just phenomenal.
We should get the two of them in a race. We're just going to see that.
The 100 metre sprint.
There was a lot of interest in him actually, and Tottenham did really well to get it over the line. He wanted to go there, he wanted to play under Ange Postecoglou and believed in that, and I feel like it's paid off so much. And if you're a Tottenham fan thinking we managed to get him in, he's got so much room to grow, so much potential, you've got to be delighted he's part of the team.
There was lots of teams in for him, but I don't know if I'm brave enough to say it yet, but his style of play is very kind of Rolls Royce. It's a little bit like a Virgil Van Dijk or a Willy Saliba, you know. I'm not quite jumping in headfirst on that one yet, but that's his style of play. Very calm, very composed. I talk about body language a lot. I like to look at how they read the game and how they hold themselves. And he just looks like he's fully in control all the time, because he knows he's got the speed to back it up as well. He knows that if he's slightly out of position, his speed will get him out of trouble again.
And Tottenham fans are loving that partnership at the back with Romero. Is there argument that this is the best centre-back pairing that Spurs have seen?
I think there actually is argument for that, because we talk about balance between the two players, and we know Romero can be a little bit fiery and feisty at times. And I think he provides the calm alongside that and the composure, because as you mentioned, he knows he's got that pace to kind of track back on and get back as well. I really like that the centre-back pairing between the two of them. And when he drops out the team, you really see how Tottenham aren't able to set up in the same way. He's been really key to that system and really allow them to play Ange Postecoglou's style of football. But one thing I want to mention as well is how much he seems to be loving playing at Tottenham. He's already referred to his teammates as his brothers. I think he's referred to Postecoglou as like a father figure to him, which just shows how well he's settled and how liked he is by his teammates in that dressing room and by the fans as well.
Yeah, for sure. This Tottenham team is perfect for him. Like I say, you've got Romero next to him. You know he's going to be aggressive. You know that he's going to be the one that's going to be going in there and flying in for those tackles. Mickey van der Ven can come round, cover him. He likes to get the ball at his feet. He likes to come out of it. It's that Dutch heritage, that Dutch style. That's the way that they do it. So it's a perfect fit for Spurs.
Okay, let's talk Brentford centre-back Nathan Collins. Ben, is he a player you would have liked playing in front of you?
Exactly that. Exactly that. He's the sort of player that I know what I'm going to get from him. He knows his capabilities, he knows his limitation, and he just stays within those two boundaries. Big lad, very, very comfortable on the ball, but you know that he's going to be physical, he's going to get in people's faces, he's going to step in when he needs to, and he's going to be a threat in the boxes as well.
Yeah, he's very good with the ball at his feet, and for centre-backs now, increasingly, they're becoming a key part of the build-up play, aren't they? And when you've got a player like that who is comfortable driving forward with the ball, dribbling through the opposition, that's a really key strength for a centre-back now.
He is great to watch, isn't he? Because his commitment to the defensive cause is second to none. He's a very brave player, which does sometimes mean he makes mistakes, but he always gives 100%. You know you're going to get that much from him.
He's a big unit as well. He's a big, big unit. Again, there's a time and a place for it. It's like a throwback. You don't get too many of them nowadays. Reminds me of a sort of a Craig Dawson type of player. You know he's going to be a threat in both boxes. But again, it's just that reliability of I know what I'm going to get from him at any given moment.
And sometimes when you mention the bravery there as well, it is a bit of a risk reward, isn't it? And if you've got a centre-back who is really good on the ball and will try those more difficult passes or try and dribble with the ball as well, sometimes they're going to get caught out. But you also know what you're going to get in terms of an attacking sense. And he really contributes on that side of the game as well.
I think it's a risk reward for Brentford as well. It's been a tough season for Brentford in general. So that he's probably been under a lot more pressure than what he's used to or what he should have been. But the way that they want to play, Thomas Frank, he likes to get the ball out from the back. He likes to play it, so playing out more, you're going to get exposed to more mistakes, and that's just the kind of the nature of the beast, I suppose.
Well, that brings us to the end of our players for episode one, but we're not done just yet. Guys, got time for a quick game?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. All right, Ben, you are up first. You've got just 15 seconds to pick three players that we've discussed today. You're going to captain one, you want to start one, and you're bringing on one as a super sub.
15 seconds.
You got this?
No.
I'm glad you're going first.
I hope you do, because your time starts now.
Okay, captain Mickey van der Ven, because in my team I'm playing a high line and I need that pace so Mickey van der Ven can cover and help his teammates out. Willy Saliba goes into the starting 11 for sure, nice and calm and composed, and I need that effect on the rest of the team. And I've got to show a bit of goalie love to James Trafford. It's been a tough season for him, but it's all good learning and it'll hold him in good stead for the future. That was 15 seconds.
I tell you what, that was a phenomenal effort from you, Ben. But Harriet, it's your turn to go on the clock. You can't say the same. Are you ready?
No, ready.
Off you go.
I'm captaining Saliba. I think he already possesses so many of those leadership qualities. I'm going to start Van der Ven. You can't leave that pace on the bench, can you? And then my super sub is going to be Branthwaite, because he'll bring that composure for the last 5-10 minutes of the game.
Oh, brilliant.
And breathe. You both absolutely smashed that. That was unbelievable. Guys, thank you so much. I hope you've enjoyed yourself. Make sure you join us next time when we take a look at another group of young players right here on Premier League Rising Stars, presented by Hublot.